So yesterday we gave an introduction about the importance of Juz Amma, and we started, we are in Musta'id Billah, A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem, Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Inna yawma al-fasli kana miqata, yawma yunfakhu fi s-suri fata'tuna afwaja, wa futihat as-sama'u fakanat abwaba, wa suyirat al-jibalu fakanat saraba. إن جهنم كانت مرصادا للطاغين مآبا لابثين فيها أحقابا لا يذوقون فيها بردا ولا شرابا إلا حميما وغساقا جزاء وفاقا إنهم كانوا لا يرجون حسابا وكذبوا بآياتنا كذابا وكل شيء أحصيناه كتابا فذوقوا فلن نزيدكم إلا عذابا. So we said that in جزء عما, the theme of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning those who disbelieve and putting some imagery, some scenes of Akhirah to say this is what is waiting for you if you when you leave this world, as a warning and as such vivid imagery of the Day of Judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in these verses, إِنَّ يَوْمَ الْفَصْلِ كَانَ مِقَاتَ. So the day of Fasl. Fasl is when you separate between two things. When you discriminate, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on Judgment Day separates between the believers and unbelievers. إِنَّ يَوْمَ الْفَصْلِ means verily there's an appointed, allotted time for the day when Allah sorts out those who believed in Him from those who didn't believe in Him. إِنَّ يَوْمَ الْفَصْلِ كَانَ مِقَاتًا يَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ فَتَأْتُونَ أَفْوَاجًا. The day when Sayyidina Mikael takes the trumpet and blows the trumpet, this is the second blow when everybody is resurrected. Everybody comes out. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, when on the day when the trumpet will be blown and you shall all come forth in crowds, afwaj, like one crowd, one group after one group. On that day, in tafsir Sayyid Ibn Kathir, he quotes the verse, يَوْمَ نَدْعُوا كُلَّ أُنَاسٍ بِإِمَامِهِمْ, that day, means the groups that I will be coming, every group is coming with their imam. So as Muslims, we are lucky to have Sayyidul Anbiya as our Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We hope when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls his ummah, that we will be in the group behind him, called, and he is our imam. يَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ فَتَأْتُونَ أَفْوَاجًا. We'll be coming in groups. And in the hadith that Sayyidina Abu Huraira says, مَا بَيْنَ النَّفْخَتَيْنِ أَرْبَعُونَ. So between the first blow and everything, فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. The first blow, everybody ceases to be. That's the first. And the second blow, when everybody is resurrected, when Sayyidina Mikael blows the horn. So Sayyidina Abu Huraira said between that Prophet ﷺ say, between the first blow and the last blow, 40, he said. And they tried to ask him 40 days, 40 months, 40 years. He wouldn't answer. And then he said, ثُمَّ يُنَزِّلُ اللَّهَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً فَيَنْبُتُونَ كَمَا يَنْبُتُ الْبَقْرِ. Then Prophet ﷺ said, then Allah will bring forth a water, special water, that on earth, and then the people will resurrect, yambutun, they will grow as if like the green plants grow. The shoots come out of the earth. That's how كَمَا يَنْبُتُ الْبَقْلِ, the greenery, vegetation. And he said, صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم, لَيْسَ مِنَ الْإِنسَانِ شَيْءٌ إِلَّا يَبْلَى, means human beings, when they're buried, everything will decompose, everything will disappear, turn into soil, except one small part at the tail of the spine. It's called عُجْبُ الذَّنَب, or I think it's called coccyx, something like that in English. So a small bone will remain that is indestructible, that when the water, that water reaches it, everybody will come back resurrected fully. وَفُتِحَتِ السَّمَاءُ فَكَانَتْ أَبْوَابًا, and the gates of the heavens are open. At that time, people will see all in heaven. وَسُيِّرَتِ الْجِبَالُ فَكَانَتْ سَرَابًا, and these mountains that we see magnificent, steady, still, at that time, people will see them moving like sarab, like mist, like clouds. وترى الجبال تحسبها جامدة وهي تمر مر السحاب. And in another surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you see the mountains, you think it is solid, but it is moved clouds. And in Surah Yasin, وتكون الجبال كالعهن المنفوش, means at that time the mountains will look like the wool when you pull it. That's how the mountains would look. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْجِبَالِ وَيَوْمَ نُسَيِّرُ الْجِبَالَ وَتَرَى الْأَرْضَ بَارِزَةً. Also another verse talking about mountains will look, people will see them moving, not steady. And then the verse, إِنَّ جَهَنَّمَ كَانَتْ مِرْصَادًا لِلطَّاغِينَ مَآبًا لَابِثِينَ فِيهَا أَحْقَابًا. That verily, Jahannam is waiting in ambush. That Allah created Jahannam for His disobedient servant, for His disbelieving servants, and it is waiting. Mirsad means it is wait, like it can't wait until it gets its delivery. Inna Jahannama kanat mirsada littaghina, for those who transgressed. Ma'aba means it's going to be a home. It's going to be their abode. لَابِثِينَ فِيهَا أَحْقَابًا, and they will spend whatever Allah wants them to spend of time. And this in tafsir means this is for the believing but disobedient servants that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends for punishment, because Allah is saying they will stay in it portions of time. So it's not for those who deny Allah's existence. We know that they have eternal khulud, they have eternally staying there. But this, since the verse indicates that a portion of time, Sayyidina Ibn Kathir is saying that this is pertaining to people who believe in Allah, but they deserved some punishment. But also in the tafsir, he said there's another tafsir to this, that ahqab doesn't specify any time, other than in general meaning of eternity. So it could be for believers, it could be for those who don't believe. لَابِثِينَ فِيهَا أَحْقَابًا لَا يَذُوقُونَ فِيهَا بَرْدًا وَلَا شَرَابًا. They will never taste any coolness in it or drink in it, cool drink. Means they cannot quench their thirst nor cool their environment. إلا حميما وغساقا. حميم is it is the opposite of coolness. وغساق, it is, this also been said by رابع أنس in reference to حميم, it is the heat that has reached its maximum temperature and point of boiling. So the hamim is the maximum, and ghassaq is the liquid made from pus and sweat and tears and wounds of the people of hellfire. So very graphic imagery for those who يعني take these things lightly. May Allah forgive us. We are looking for Allah's mercy as believers. But these verses started عَمَّا يَتَسَأَلُونَ. Allah is talking to those who deny Him, deny His existence or the existence of Akhirah. جَزَاءً وِفَاقًا, meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to oppress anyone. It will be according to what they did, according to their wicked deeds, their punishment will be. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, what is their ailment and sickness? إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا لَا يَرْجُونَ حِسَابًا. People didn't believe in accounting, didn't believe that one day they will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and account for their deeds. وَكَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا كِذَّابًا. And they have denied and lied and denied our signs, our proofs, its existence, that there is a Lord, there is a designer. They've denied all this and they've denied Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They've rejected. وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ أَحْصَيْنَاهُ كِتَابًا. And everything we have recorded in a book. So اقرأ كتابك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell يوم الحساب, read your book. Everything is in your book. Everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala happening in this existence is in a book. Surely we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the deeds of all the creatures. Allah فذوقوا فلن نزيدكم إلا عذابا. Since you didn't believe, and I've sent you prophets, and I've sent you messengers and books, and you insisted and you've denied my signs, then taste. You are not going to, the only thing that will increase for you is the amount of punishment. إِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ مَفَازًا. Then the verses go to hear the switch. So here he was talking about the unbelievers. Now, for those who accepted and believe, إِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ مَفَازًا حَدَائِقَ وَأَعْنَابًا وَكَوَاعِبَ أَتْرَابًا وَكَأْسًا دِهَاقًا لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا كذابا جزاء من ربك عطاء حسابا. So the great success for those who have taqwa, who have belief, is that great for those muttaqeen, they have in akhirah, they will realize that they have achieved a great success, that their belief and deeds and struggles and strives and hardship they went to stay steadfast on in believing cause them to be from the great, those who attain greater success. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, what kind of imagery? حدائق, gardens and gardens. وأعناب, all kinds of fruits. اللهم صلي على عنب is grapes. وكواعب أترابا. And also, they will have other enjoyments. وَكَأْسًا دِهَاقًا. And Sayyidina Ibn Abbas said that their cups will be continuously filled from all kinds of delightful drinks. دِهَاقًا, that means completely filled. وَكَأْسًا دِهَاقًا. لَا يَسْمَعُونَ فِيهَا لَغْوًا وَلَا كِذَّابًا. In Akhirah, in heaven, people will not hear any gossip, any lies, any nonsense. لا لغوا فيها ولا تأثيم. Free from any لغو, which is just nonsense, useless talk. Any vain, worthless speech or lying. جزاء من ربك عطاء حسابا. So this is a very good point. The people of heaven, Prophet ﷺ described them as those who have the characteristics worthy of heaven. The humble ones, كُلُّ ضَعِيفٍ مُتَضَعَفٍ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا. People with humility, يَأْلَفُونَ وَيُؤْلَفُونَ, easygoing, happy, good, people are happy to be with them. Not judgmental, don't talk nonsense, don't lie, don't cheat, so forth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving indication that in heaven that will not exist, for because these people tried in this world to stay away and refrain from these things. جَزَاءً مِّن رَبِّكَ عَطَاءً حِسَابًا. We'll stop here inshallah, and we will continue tomorrow. Means these people, we will be rewarded by their Lord, a great reward, عطاء, and Allah's grants are endless. There's no limits to his gifts. Abundance. Inshallah, tomorrow we will continue. We're almost done with Surah Amma. Wa min Allahi tawfiq. Bi hurmati al-habib. Bi hurmati al-fatiha. Salli ala Muhammad. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Again, I remind you on myself, at the time of iftar, don't waste your dua. When you sit down to break your iftar, make your dua. Allah, Prophet ﷺ said that that time is accepted dua, inshaAllah. And barakallah feekum. Jazakumullah khairan for joining us. Allah bless you. Anyone who said salamu alaykum salam, keep us in your dua. And we will meet again tomorrow. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.